Go ahead.
Zechariah 12 and 8. In that day shall Yahweh defend the inhabitants of Jerusalem. And he that is feeble among them at that day shall be as David. And the house of David shall be as God, and the angel of Yahweh before him.
He's gonna have power, gonna be strong as shit. Just like I was about to say, man. Ain't nothing like a motherfucker that's already angry as fuck given spiritual power. And you know what happens when a motherfucker get what they, you ever watch that movie Juice with Tupac?
Yeah.
The motherfucker got a gun, but they feel powerful, like, you know? They feel like they the shit, man. Living carnal as hell, that gun. But think about a motherfucker that's already mad, righteously mad over some righteous shit, you know? Giving power then. Man, he gonna be just fed tearing through these motherfuckers like a lawnmower. Like David. David was a bad motherfucker, man. David was bad as shit.
Yeah, he run through a whole troop, a whole army.
Fuck being like Mike. Fuck faggot ass being like Mike. Faggot ass Michael Jordan. Be like Mike. I'm gonna be like Mike. Nah, I'm gonna be like King David.
Only thing Michael Jordan did was dribble a basketball. Mm-hmm.
Put
balls through holes.
Right.
Jump 10 feet in the air.
Yeah, that's a great man. He put balls in holes.
And wow, he dunked on a 10-foot basketball rim. Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah, they say Michael Jordan's a prick too, man.
The scriptures say King David killed thousands. He killed like tens of thousands of people. Michael Jordan ain't killed nobody.
Right, dude.
You know what I'm saying?
Right,
well, you know, on the battlefield.
Killed his father.
He killed his dad. He did some. King David killed some right. Killed righteous. Going righteous at killing. Michael Jordan killed his dad with some unrighteous shit. You know?
This is some faggot shit out here.
So, 18.
That's why I stay disconnected from this shit as much as I fucking possibly can. I don't want to be part of none of this shit. Want none of this shit.
Hell no.
Don't want to be part of this shit. Sometimes you have to go out in the world, go to grocery shop, and you gotta go do stupid shit.
Yep.
Other than that, man, I don't go out there. I ain't trying to be part of this fucking shit, man.
I curse this world.
Only fucking thing there is bars.
Yeah,
go bars, to movies.
Right. To meet some adulterous hoes and be around some adulterous ass Israelites.
Watch some foosball.
Then the cops will just pull you over on the way out. Right, post it up right outside the bar. Yeah, these people, man, we surrounded by heathens. I fucking hate these people. Go ahead with that.
Psalms 18:31. Who is God save Yahweh? Or who is a rock save our God? It is God that girdeth me with strength and maketh my way perfect. He maketh my feet like high feet and setteth me upon high places. He teaches my hands to war so that a bow of steel is broken by my arms.
Man, that sounds like a man with superpowers.
Oh, that's, yeah.
You know?
Broke a bow of steel with his arms. Keep going.
I gotta get this precept for that.
That song's, 18, ain't it?
Yeah. I gotta get this precept on that, because it's all kind of examples of motherfuckers that's able to do superhuman strength. Like, you go to a crazy house, man, it takes like 10 motherfucking wardens to hold down somebody that's going buck crazy, man.
Oh, yeah?
You know? There's another example in the Bible where the dude, crazy motherfucker, broke chains.
That was a guy that was possessed with legion.
Like legion, dude. What's that legion?
Yeah, said he broke chains.
You know? So these muscles can do a lot of shit, man. Just the Most High guy put it in. He's the one, like the scripture saying, man, he's the one that grant that power to do it.
But, thou hast also given me the shield of thy salvation, and thy right hand hath holding me. But holding me up in thy gentleness have made me great. Thou hast enlarged my steps under me, that my foot did not slip. I have pursued my enemies and overtaken them. Neither did I turn again till they were consumed.
You ever seen a lion run or a cheetah or a cat, period? Their grip, they don't slip. They just, it's just that they at top speed as soon as they stop short running. They're already at top speed. They just cone, man. That's a wonderful feeling. These motherfuckers now, they gotta put on cleats and shit. Some fucking cleats. Some goddamn cleats. some expensive ass cleats. That's some bad shit you go once you go into it, man. What's that, Zephaniah?
Watch that show, Avatar: The Last Airbender.
Oh, that's the... Oh, yeah.
The cartoon?
The cartoon.
Yeah, that's some bad shit.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I've seen that.
Yeah.
That shit. Water, because, like, the... Well, is he had power with water because he put his hand out with water to play.
Mm-hmm.
Boy, it's like, what's her name? What's that bitch name in Storm? She had white hair, and she controlled the weather and shit like that.
The X-Men?
Yeah, they mocked the Lord. Because the Lord...
Exactly what they made him a bitch.
No, a suicide bomber.
I never thought about that. Damn, I never even thought I looked at it that way. But they made him a woman. Yep, gray hair.
She was an African.
And you know what? Funny thing is, with X-Men, Storm is actually the wisest one out of all of them. She's actually the wise one.
That's scary.
That's not scriptural. The woman being the wisest.
Logan's adulteress. I would be fucking with Storm. He was being adulteress.
Right. Yeah. What's her name?
There's all adulterers. Wolverine's an adulterer.
Mm-hmm. He's trying to fuck up.
He's fucking Cyclops' wife, Jean Grey.
Yeah, Jean. That's Jean. Storm. Storm hot, man. I got a picture of Storm on my phone, man. That's how the woman gonna be built. Let me show you.
There's all kind of faggot shit in comics, man. That's why Peter Parker, he left his fucking bitch. No, what was it? Peter Parker or... And no, in the Spider-Man movie, Peter Parker was fighting to get with a bitch who'd already been with some other dude. You know what I mean? Mary Jane. Mary Jane was a hoe. And he's fighting over a hoe.
And she was fighting. She was already fucking with dude that turned into Venom.
Yeah, in the movie. Yeah. That's that adultery they push in the movie.
Lana Lane a hoe.
Oh, Lana and Lois. They both hoes. That shit run in the family.
Yep.
That shit ain't talking like it's real. but yeah, because here it is. Superman got powers. And he's fighting to get with a goddamn hoe. That tells you that's how they brainwash and manipulate people's minds with the comic books. They use comic books to manipulate little children's minds. If little kids growing up, they watching cartoons and comic books, they got faggots in it, they'll think faggots is okay. Did you know they had a faggot Green Lantern, right? They came out with a recent... Green Lantern.
I thought they was turning Spider-Man gay.
No more women gonna be built like that again. That's some beautiful shit right there.
That's pretty nice.
You know? They gonna be built like that again. And this probably ain't giving real justice to how it's really gonna be.
Talking about the X-Men, did you know they turned Iceman into a faggot? Iceman, one of the original X-Men.
Right. He was, wasn't he?
Yeah, one of the original five, right?
Yeah.
They turned him into a faggot.
I'm not surprised.
It's like, what kind of shit is that?
That's to boost the sales. They're trying to make sales now because everybody's fucking faggot.
Boost the sales and push their propaganda. Oh, it just came out of the news last week. I don't know if you've seen it. It said transsexuals are 49 times more likely to catch HIV than anyone else. 49 times. Now once or twice, two twice, 49 times.
And that's off of statistics.
Yeah, well, off the government statistics.
Yep. That's beautiful though. That's just beautiful. You know, back in Sodom and Gomorrah, they was probably walking around leaving pus trails, you know?
Yeah, they do that here. That's why, all these transsexuals, if they be getting mad while we make fun of them or talk shit about them, but they all got AIDS.
Oh, Charlie Sheen got AIDS.
Yeah, Charlie Sheen got AIDS. They said he was fucking transsexual. That's where he got it from. That's what he deserved. That's what happens when you fuck trannies, you get AIDS.
We already knew these entertainers and motherfucking entertainers and musicians and shit and a bunch of fucking facts.
They do weird shit.
Yeah, a lot of them athletes too. A whole lot of them athletes. Big motherfucking big muscle bound motherfucker. Oh, shit! I'm going down past, I don't know where the fuck I was going, but I was out at, by Easton, going to some new apartments they got built in Stelson. So a big ass motherfucking nigga, man, light skinned nigga, man, with nothing but makeup and shit on, man, mascara. He was dressed normal though, but he was, you know, that was his mascara, makeup, lipstick. Standing there at the bus stop, just waiting, man. I couldn't believe what the fuck I saw, man.
That's what them old rock and roll groups used to do. They still do that, man. We wearing mascara and shit. That's some faggot shit.
Papa Roach. Yeah, dude wearing all kinds
of... He's a big faggot. I don't listen to that faggot shit.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, I could tell by these motherfucking spirit that the crew lost, and they did.
Who the fuck gets all emotionally invested in the soccer?
I ain't never been to soccer yet.
Soccer?
You know what? These women, man, coming out of high school that play soccer, they just be built nice, too. You know, I ain't never liked the game myself, but I played it, though.
I mean, it's all
right. I've never played soccer.
It ain't no excitement. I mean, Pele made it had excitement. You watch some Brazilians, they make it a little exciting on the tricks and shit.
Oh, yeah, this shit overseas looks exciting.
Yeah, they better, man. They better than these motherfuckers boring here, man.
Yeah.
They boring here. They have no swerve to this shit. No sweetness, no smoothness to
it. At the end of the day, all they're doing is kicking a ball around.
Pretty much.
There's, ain't nothing, it's no like an hour-long game. I don't know. The game's like 2 hours or something, but the score is always like 2-1 or 1-0. Yeah. Long-ass game of kicking a ball up and down the field.
It's rare to see a game that's like 10-12 and shit. That's rare as hell. And it do happen, though. Crowd be going crazy. No motherfuckers be getting killed after soccer games overseas.
Look, they all was at the game. They look
killed
sad.
After soccer games, but they won't riot after, over nothing that matters.
Righteous shit.
Yeah, never.
Nothing righteous. Nothing righteous. Nothing righteous.
That's why these faggot-ass cops can go around fucking with everybody.
Well,
right, good, right, those are our brothers, though. I love them.
You know, well, when we give them spiritual power, man, we're going to show how brotherly we really fucking are, man. We're going to show how brotherly, we're going to show some brotherly love.
Yeah, they're going to
give them spiritual power. So, this is some right, this is some fame, this is some terrible shit to live in, man. And you want to talk about the word oppression, this is oppression on steroids. You feel oppressed here in America?
Love America.
Right. You see on the internet bitches posting love and life. Life is beautiful.
Only
that's
a hocus.
That's a bitch on Percocets every day.
Yeah, on Percocets. Yeah, she
getting cock shoved down her throat.
Right, right. That's the bitch. Loving life. Yeah. Loving life.
They'd be high every fucking second. So if they wasn't high, it's Isaiah 60. And they, who are these that fly as a cloud and as the doves to their windows?
Who are these?
It's a dove to the windows, Paul. You don't remember that guy?
He was looking all over for that scripture.
I'll never forget that
Revelation.
This is years ago. This
like
guy,
two doves on the window. You know what I'm talking about.
There's some retarded dude who came up here, and he kept going on about the doves in the windows. I know that scripture's in there. I forget what every time I hear that scripture, I think of that guy. That was years and years ago. Oh, go ahead. Let's talk about, where are you still at?
I see you.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Yeah, I'll be geeking. I'm always looking for new cartoons. I'll be telling them about it all the time. Every time I see a new one, man, I'll be bringing it up, man.
Yeah, I like the cartoons.
I'm always looking for it. I found a badass cartoon, zombie cartoon, yesterday. It's some bad shit, man.
What, on Netflix?
It's a badass cartoon. No, Toon Movies, I think. I think it's the Toon Movies. Yeah, it's some bad shit, man. I think it's new.
Here goes your homies, they tracking us.
That wasn't one.
No, they was 118, that's 48.
I'm just paranoid now.
I watched the show, what's it called? The Legends of Korra. It's gay because, you know, some woman doing it, but it's so fucking bad, you know, fight scenes and shit.
What's it called?
Legends of Korra.
Is that Japanese?
Nah, well, it's like a Last Airbender.
Okay. Who makes that? Last Airbender. What the Japanese?
That's Nickelodeon. Shit.
Is it Nickelodeon?
Yeah, but I don't know who makes it. They just,
because you look at the art, it don't look like somebody here. It just, I mean, I could be wrong.
Probably is. You never know.
I could be wrong though.
They use like a some type of fight, like Chinese or Japanese style fight.
Right.
Some
type of
Japanese.
Yeah. That's that Song of Solomon. The scripture said, the Lord teaches my hands to war.
Nice.
You know what I'm saying?
Nice. That's right.
Hey, where's that scripture that talks about how, man, I haven't brought this one out in a long time. about how the David's mighty men, one
it's
of
the spirit, because I was looking for
he
that.
Could throw rocks with one hand and shoot the bow with the other. What was that? You know what I'm talking about, right? We pulled that out a long time ago. Like, he was like ambidextrous. He could use both hands in battle.
Yeah, that's me. I used to be. You lose it, you don't use it. Shit.
You got a sword in one hand and an axe in the other.
I'm not talking about myself. Because it depresses me. It really do, man. Because personally, I think the Lord did that just to give you an idea of, you know, pretty much. If it's on your mind once you did something and you can't do it no more, it's like budget. It bothers you, you know, because you know you're in your mind, your body's deteriorating, you're rotten, and you're falling apart, you know. Shit, man.
Yeah.
It's kind of depressing, but the thing that lifts me up is we're going to be given power again.
We got a scripture for that now. 2 Corinthians is about how every day you die.
Every day, yeah, every day.
Even though your body is weak and but your mind is fresh, something like that. I can do it.
Hold on, I'm trying to find one scripture real quick. It's a bad scripture, too.
I was looking for that one in Chronicles.
I gotta find this one scripture. I'm gonna try and get this real quick. This ain't nothing but spiritual power all through this book, man. And I'm like a child. I want to read about it every day. You know what I'm saying? It's like just our baddest comic book, man, which is our history. What better comic book to, what better book to read is your history when you were superhuman, you know? I'm like a child, man. Okay, this is... Which one did you read for Isaiah? Remember, do you remember?
16.
Okay. Let me hold up. You got to put that vibration out there, man. You get fed up with shit and you want to kill. You want to start tearing shit up, man. What did Daryl say he did with his knife? Started cutting shit up. Couch or some shit, a chair. You know, it do, man. Once you go through enough of this shit, man, you don't go crazy. Here we go. This is 2 Samuel 2, and I'm going to start at 2 and 8. These be the names of the mighty men whom David had. The Tachmon knight that sat in the seat, chief among the captains. The same was Adino, the Esnite. He lifted up his spear against 800 whom he slew one at one time.
800? He killed 800 at once?
Motherfucker had problems with one motherfucker now. Shit.
800? Damn.
800, you know? 800!
That's like some video game shit. Like, yep, you play exactly. A beat 'em up?
Yep, exactly. That's beautiful, man. That is beautiful. Oh, here we go. 2 Samuel 22 and 29. For thou art my lamp, O Lord, and the Lord will lighten my darkness. For by thee I have run through a troop. By my power have I leaped over a wall.
He said leapt over a wall. Back in
fuck Michael Jordan, man.
But a wall, that's in the ancient world, all the cities were surrounded by walls. Big, giant, 20-foot walls.
Shit, back then they had to protect themselves.
Probably higher than 20-feet wall.
Yeah, probably higher. Yeah,
probably high as fuck.
Probably a lot higher. Yep.
Yeah, it'd be big enough to keep people out. Yeah.
So we can imagine they were like, I mean, goddamn, man, you see, I'm going to pull up a picture of like the gates when you go in the city. Let me pull up a picture, man.
How they became the general defense in the first trouble.
People can't comprehend this, man, if they don't have have a spiritual eye. If they all think it carnal, and Michael Jordan is the best you can get, Charles Barkley, gay ass LeBron James. They think that's the best we have. That's the best we've ever been. Fucking LeBron James, what the fuck? And them niggas ain't doing no jumping at all, man. You go and watch the Olympics high jumpers and jumpers that do the long, that's some shit.
He's damn 6'8", 6'10".
He should be able to jump high. Shit.
Yeah, a lot of them NBA dudes are just big. I cannot find this scripture, man. I'm gonna find it. Oh, well, hey, this is that same scripture you read.
Woo-wee.
You know the Psalm of David is in the book of Samuel and the book of Psalms? You know that it appears twice?
Oh, yeah.
In Psalms 18, it's also in 2 Samuel. He says, 2 Samuel 22 and 35, he teaches my hands to war so that a bow is still broken by my arms.
See how little they are? Here we go. Can the camera pick that up?
Yeah, probably not. I don't know.
I'm
going to
have to turn the brightness up, make the contrast up a little bit. Cause
what is that? The ancient city wall?
That's one of them, yeah.
They get way bigger than that.
Yeah, you're right, they do.
Nobody, you don't know nobody can jump over there.
Because the castle walls,
that's the smallest as they get. Who do you know that can jump over that?
Exactly.
Nobody. But David said he leapt over a wall.
This is us, man. You know what I'm saying?
You like
this is us, man.
You know how the Incredible Hulk used to jump? Well, he jumped so fast. He thought he was flying.
Yeah, yeah.
He didn't fly. He just jumped real far.
That's some big thoughts. Yeah. I love them dreams, man. When I'm even in control. I just start floating away. Just start flying. Just don't want nobody touch me. I'm watching, and you know that's some reality shit too. Your dreams, man. Because you're looking down on shit, and everything is familiar. You know, everything's familiar, like you've been there before. You know, that's beautiful, man. That's like the walls kinked, like that Samson tore off and carried them away. Yeah. Who does the teleporting? The lizard dude.
Nightcrawler.
Yeah, that's some bad shit. We can do a whole lot of that.
Yeah, I know all about the X-Men shit. I was raised on that shit.
I didn't get to see the newest one yet, but I watched that one.
Oh, fuck the movies. I read the comics, son. The original shit. All they do, I give up looking for that scripture. Hey, but there's a scripture, was it Kings or Chronicles? Where it said one of David's mighty men, he could throw a stone with one hand and use a bow with the other. I cannot remember where that scripture's at, but it's in there, I assure you. Maybe it was a Benjamite, I can't remember.
I remember the two hands.
Yeah, he could fight with both hands.
That's one of those scriptures we had. We count.
We used to pull it out.
Home by
yeah.
I'm gonna try to find it.
Good luck. Yeah, get Matthew 10:34. Yeah, because we in the time of destruction anyway. Yeah, this shit out here gotta be destroyed, man. This shit's gotta fucking go.
Absolutely must.
It needs to go soon.
Yeah. It absolutely must.
Immediately.
Go.
ASAP.
That's right. That's right.
Not another goddamn minute.
That's right.
Read that.
There's a scripture that says that they wore out the saints of the Most High.
Yeah.
They wore them out. That's physically and mentally.
Yep.
You know? That's physically and mentally. You can go, there's only so much stress your body can go through, man. So much stress your body can take. So we have to get out of here. The Bible says, so he's speeding up time for his elect's sake to get us up out of here anyway. You know? What you got on?
You said Matthew
10:34.
Think not that I come to send peace on earth. I came not to send peace, but a sword.
Yeah, because that goes with everything we was talking about. Because when the Lord comes back, he coming back to give everybody a hug and to No, the Lord's coming back to destroy. He's going to destroy all this wicked shit. All these wicked ass people. They got to go. They all got to be destroyed.
That's right.
They got to be eliminated.
Burnt the fuck up. They get their it's time to give them their reward. You know?
Right, because the scripture said the Lord's a man of war. You know what I'm saying? It didn't say the Lord's a faggot. Okay, it said the Lord's a man of war. Okay, and the Lord is going to kill and destroy. That's what's going to happen. What are you looking for?
Ezekiel says that they might vengeance upon
you. That's Ezekiel 25.
That's some bad shit. A lot of movies quoted that one. Like, I think that was Pulp Fiction.
Is that it? Is that when they took Esau out of it, though, didn't they? They fucked it up. They didn't read it right.
Yeah, they changed it.
Quentin Tarantino's a big fucking weirdo. He's a big fucking faggot and a big fucking weirdo. You know what I'm saying? I don't like none of his movies. I don't watch that shit. Go ahead.
Ezekiel 25 and 14. And I will lay my vengeance upon Edom by the hand of my people Israel.
Yeah, because Edom controls all this shit. So they gonna get, when the Lord gives us the power, they gonna get hands laid upon them.
They shall do in Edom according to my anger and according to my fury, and they shall know my vengeance, saith the Lord God.
So they gonna know the vengeance. Yeah, they're going to get destroyed, man. They're going to get torn apart from every goddamn limb. Mm-hmm. Go ahead, there's more to that.
They don't see it coming, though.
No.
They see something else coming. You know? They see trouble coming, but they see a trouble that they can recover from.
Oh, what does it say? No, you can skip up. There's more to it. It doesn't matter. Because it goes on and on what's going to happen to Esau.
Yeah, that's some kind of shit right there.
Yeah.
That's the butter right there.
Start at 12.
Yeah.
12. Thus saith the Lord God, because that Edom hath dealt against the house of Judah by taking vengeance, and have greatly offended and revenged himself upon them. Therefore, thus saith the Lord God, I will also stretch out my hand upon Edom, and I will cut off man and beast from it, and I will make it desolate. Taman and day of Edom shall fall by the sword.
Calling out names, right?
All of Esau's lands is going to be laid desolate. America's going to be laid desolate. This shit ain't going to be nothing left out of this raggedy motherfucker.
No, motherfucker.
This shit's going to be fucking destroyed. We can't wait till this shit gets destroyed.
For real.
Hey, there ain't nothing to like out here.
What was that picture? Where's that scripture? The smoke? The go out?
Isaiah 34.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
That goes talking about Esau too.
Shit, go back to that spiritual powers. You're gonna see all the times you got put to death in your old life.
Oh man. You're gonna see all that, man. You're gonna see who did it. Who did it? You know, especially the Israelites that did it. You know? We could ask Israelites. Yep, all of them motherfuckers. If the Most High ain't already put them to death. You know? If you ain't already put them to death, but you can still see it, though. If you want to see it. You know? That's going to be bad, man.
Well, you talking about in the kingdom, you see everything, right?
You can see it all.
Probably get to watch old battles and everything.
That's what I want to see.
Yeah.
That's what I want to see.
You know, say all the famous battles, we get to watch them.
Yeah. Esau documentaries is just weak as fuck, man.
In the movie, and all the movies too, man. The movies put a false impression in your mind of what really happened.
False impression, false images.
Yeah, all the images is false.
Everything false. But they give you places and all that shit.
Yeah, yeah.
They do give you certain photos of walk, you know, castles or, you know, certain shit, but they can make them better than that, though. You go far, they can make them far better than what they do. And that's what I'm waiting to see.
They can't never just give you a straight up Bible movie. They always gotta, you know, give you shit to what didn't happen in the original story. They have yet to make an Exodus movie where everything happened exactly as it said in the Bible.
Oh, man.
They got to switch little shit up.
Right. I watched Mary of Nazareth the other day.
Oh, I ain't fucking...
Is that what you're talking about?
You want to talk about some bugged out shit? Yeah, Mary of Nazareth, not Jesus.
The bottom
Nazareth,
there.
It was Mary of Nazareth. The whole movie was on Mary just been the holiest hoe in the world, man. For real. And they was going off like a muffin. It was actually heathens playing the parts, too. They had a couple of jakes in it, but they was actually heathens. No, no.
It says they're able to handle shield and spear.
Oh, no, that's not it. It's around there somewhere. That's a nice Bible. What Bible is that?
Oh, no.
That's pretty slick. No, there's a scripture that says... there's a scripture that says they could had throw stones with one hand and shoot a bow with the other. I forget where it's at. It's like, man, yeah, man, this shit right here, this just gotta fucking go. Raggedy ass country, man. This is a big pile of shit. You get depressed just looking at people. You know what I'm saying? You just see all these dumbass people, you look at them. That shit brings you down, seeing how stupid these motherfuckers are. Like, goddamn, how can you be so goddamn stupid?
Yeah, my class, I told you about that. We could just argue in the class, man. It's so fucking annoying how they be arguing. I don't know. It's just vexation.
And like they actually got some kind of valid point to make.
I think they're so fucking sweet and knowledgeable.
That sounds like torture, being up in that school.
Like, oh, man.
At least you ain't got to go to school all day. You only go a half a day. Yeah, praise the Lord for that, man. I wish I went to high school for half a day. Fuck. I felt like I was in prison the whole time.
Not me, man. I was too busy looking at pussy. And I'm serious. My whole high school year was motivated by going to look at... I had crushes, man, that kept me up all night, man. You know, when you're a teenager, like your age, your testosterone level is a lot higher than what it is my age now. Your dick get hard when the wind blows, don't it? Your rod get hard when the wind blows. But like then, back then, man, you know, that was my motivation through high school was the girls, you know? I mean, who in their right mind don't want some pussy?
But that's some young pussy, too.
You know, yeah, young pussy, man. That was my motivation through high school. So I looked forward to going to school, man. I looked forward to that shit. I was a star, though, you know? I was an athlete. So I was fucked. Shit. Look at a bunch of adulterous hoes, man, because all the hoes that I have already been with other niggas, man, a few of them. I'm fortunate.
That's what it, yeah.
I have a couple virgins.
The public school system, especially high school, yeah, that's just an adultery center. I mean, there's some all young adults going into school.
That's all it is, man.
So they sending all these young people, boys and girls together, actually young men and young women, and everybody's fucking everybody. Your daughter, though, if you got a daughter, she don't stand a chance.
Hey, check it out. One of the head wrestlers he was a badass wrestler, man. And, I used to catch his ass going next door because we had a faggot next door to us growing up. I used to catch his ass going over there to beat him.
Man, that's fucking nasty.
I used to catch him, man. And the white dude, who was an Edomite, but his brother and sisters were, I don't know, they might have been Terrence anyway. But a dude was an Edomite, and he died of AIDS.
Oh, shit.
And the black dude that was fucking him, the wrestler, I ain't seen him since.
Yeah, it's spreading AIDS.
Yep. He died of AIDS. His name was, should I say his name? Ty Hill. He died of AIDS, man. He actually died of AIDS.
That ain't no way to go.
I still remember that shit, man. Yeah, I think the whole family was, yeah, the mom, I think she was the only Jake in the whole family. And she got with a black dude, and I think the black dude was a tear. Actually, they still live here. Same house next door to my mom.
You got AIDS up in that house.
You know? And I think the mom got with the black dude that had two kids, a girl and a boy. And I think they tears, man. But the white dude, the mom's son that she had before she got with the nigga, he was a straight up Edomite. Open fag, man. Just open fag, man. Open homosexual, man. Died of AIDS. And he went here, OSU.
That's a punishment, man. Some goddamn AIDS. That's some heavy shit to deal with, is catching some goddamn AIDS. See how you like that one.
That's his reward he got.
Yeah.
I'd like to find out the nigga's name. I can't remember his name. It's been something
weird. Y'all got a scripture? I got.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
This is Song of Solomon 3, and I'm 7. 6. Who is this that cometh out of the wilderness like pillars of smoke, perfumes with myrrh and frankincense, with all powders of the merchant? Behold, his bed is with which is Solomon's, 70 valiant men are about it, of the valiant of Israel. They all hold swords.
They all hold swords, being experts in war. Is that what it says?
Yes, that's what it says. They all hold swords.
Hey, what scripture is that, man?
Song of Solomon 3:8.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Being experts in war. Every man hath his sword upon his thigh because of fear in the night.
Wow. Because they all hold swords, being experts in war. That's bad.
So man, it has to be, them nights back then, them dark nights back then, had to be horrible, man. You hear animals in the back, because that's when animals hunt the most. When the sun go down, you know.
They had lions in Israel in them days.
Yep.
Did you know?
There wasn't no women walking around freely back then. Like, nigga, get out of my face, nigga.
There used to be wild lions, even dragons.
Yep.
You know they say the dragons of the wilderness.
And they didn't have fucking skylights here fucking lighting your way.
Oh, hell no.
It was dark.
Yeah, I like that darkness, man. You
know, that's gonna be beautiful, man.
Yeah.
When all the city lights went out, man, we was at our happiest, man.
Yeah.
You know, we saw a glimpse of what's coming, man.
Fuck civilization. What they call it, civilization. Fuck this shit, man.
You know, for us to be awake, conscious, to go through them dark nights, man, was beautiful, man.
I loved it.
Yeah. For real.
I can't wait till all the city, all the lights go out.
All the shit go, yeah.
And scriptures say the day of the Lord is darkness and not light.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
And the darkness is coming, too, just like the darkness he laid over ancient Egypt. That darkness coming back.
Said the moon and the stars will not give their light.
Ooh, that's going to be some dark shit. That's all you're going to hear is screaming.
Yeah, you're going to hear screaming.
Ah!
Right, what happened in Egypt, too? During the Exodus, it got so dark that the Most High put a darkness over the land.
Yeah, they can feel it.
Yeah, you can feel it.
They can feel it. Let me see if I can find that. They can feel it.
That's some crazy shit went down in the Exodus,
man. Yeah, that's some movie shit on its own. That's a movie on its own, man.
They don't never get it right.
Some faggots that's making these movies, man.
I be watching that new one, the Exodus, and I mean, they just add so much dumbass shit. They turn the Most High to a little English boy. What the fuck was that all about? You ain't see it? Moses. Well, I guess Moses cracked his head, so he got hit on his head, and that made him see a little English boy in a burning bush.
What the fuck?
You ain't seen it? That movie's bugged out, man.
Yeah, that's a bad movie.
It's a bugged out movie.
That's terrible shit. They just went the fuck off. But they only did that shit. They only turned into some blast. They made some blasphemous ass shit to please these blasphemous ass people.
Yep.
You know? Here we go. This is Exodus 10, and I'm going to start at 19. And the Lord turned a mighty strong west wind, which took away the locusts and cast them into the Red Sea. There remained not one locust in all the coasts of Egypt. But the Lord hardened Pharaoh's heart, so that he would not let the children of Israel go. And the Lord said unto Moses, stretch out thine hand toward heaven, that there may be darkness over the land of Egypt, even darkness which may be felt.
Darkness that may be felt.
What?
Yeah.
Damn!
It's a spirit of death creeping on you.
And you know, darkness which may be felt. The Lord Most High probably had demons appearing in front of them Egyptians, smacking the shit out of them. You know, horrible image. Can you imagine something just appear in front of you, man, when it's already pitch dark?
Well, then the darkness came, and then the spirit of the angel of death came.
Woo!
Yeah. Killed all the firstborns.
Got busy.
So that was beautiful. That was a beautiful day right there.
And Moses stretched forth his hand toward heaven, and there was a thick darkness in all the land of Egypt 3 days.
3 days.
Three long-ass days.
With no light.
Damn.
Just pure darkness.
That's, that, 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 was torture.
They done went crazy after one day.
Yeah, that was torture. That was torture.
Just after a few hours, you go crazy.
The King of Terrors. That's the King of Terrors. That's the movie, name of the movie. King of Terrors. Shit. It's faggot ass shit they make. You can make a movie just on this alone. That'd be the hottest selling movie, man.
Yep.
When the what was going on during that darkness, you know? Let me be the motherfucking director. Let me go over the transcript after they finish writing so I can do some corrections. Here, there, correct that here. No, no, the woman didn't say no man. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, they have a woman hero in there.
Right,
somewhere.
Right. Nah, get that bitch out of there. She dies. She opened the door and her head gets chopped off. Shit, you know? Shit.
Hell yeah, that's how you gotta do it.
That's some crazy shit they put in movies, man. Oh, badass woman.
I can't watch movies no more because of that shit.
It's depressing, man.
Oh, did you hear that the military just officially made it official? All branches of the military.
Yep, yep.
The women can now fight in combat.
That's something to clap to, man.
Yeah, that's retarded.
That's the Russians probably like, yeah. Yeah.
Well, now they can kill you and rape you.
Yeah, they're going to rape them and then kill them, dog. Hey, so
they going to put old number six on them, dude. You don't know about the old number six. Either.
The spoilers of the war, man.
You never watched Blazing Saddles? You and your boy went up to Hedley Lamar. He's like, we got to do old number six on them. He's like, number six? He's like, we go riding into town, a romping and a whooping, killing everything in sight. Guess and he was like, what, the women too? He's like, oh, hell no. We raped the shit out of it.
Guess what I found out was supposed to play in that movie?
Who?
Richard Pryor.
Oh, that's right.
You know,
said.
He wrote that movie.
What?
Richard Pryor. He was one of the writers of the movie.
That's a classic movie,
yeah,
man.
He was supposed to star in that movie, but I can't remember why he didn't, but it was some controversy.
It was him and Gene Wilder to make the best pair anyway.
By far.
He would have killed it if he was in it. Oh, man. Yeah,
that would have been a classic, too.
It was a classic already.
I never liked it.
Blazing Saddles?
I never been a fan of that movie. Wow. I never thought it was funny at all. I thought it was stupid. I did, man.
What about the part when your boys, they come over to the Mexicans. It's like, here's your badges. It's like, badges?
Yeah, right,
we don't
right.
need no stinking badges.
Right.
They threw it back at the ass.
I watched it about 100 times, though.
Yeah, I've seen that motherfucker a lot.
I still watch it. Because it is a classic, though. They saw not one another, neither rose any from his place for 3 days, but all the children of Israel had light in their dwellings. That's why, man.
Yeah.
I can't imagine that, though.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, that's how it's going to be with us. We're going to be in light, and they're going to be in darkness. You know?
That's pretty much, well, parabolically speaking, that's how we are right now.
Exactly. You're right.
These motherfuckers are in total darkness.
That's right.
These motherfuckers are in a fucking dark abyss. They in fucking goddamn comatized.
Yeah.
Hey, there's nothing you can do for
them. They don't know it either.
They don't know. And they ain't gonna know it. They ain't gonna know it until those missiles hit them.
Yep. Watch documentaries or a movie when motherfuckers in a crazy house that's walking around doped up. They don't know they in there, and they don't know they doped up.
Oh, they yeah, they don't.
Because they just zombies, man.
That's a good analogy because, this whole fucking country is a crazy house.
Yep, that's what it is.
You know what I'm saying? Yep. The borders, you coming through the borders, that's the entrance. You know what I'm saying? They passing out meds. They put medication in the water, in the food.
Ooh-wee.
You know
I've been a witness to that, bro. I've drank water and got stoned one.
Yeah.
I don't know how, but I got... Something had me fucked up.
This is the nut house, you're right. They don't know they in it.
Yeah.
They think everything is normal.
Yeah. I call it a giant slave ship, America. It's surrounded by water.
It is. It's on water.
I call it a giant slave ship. There's a song called Slave Ship.
And there's no escape. You in the middle of the goddamn surrounded by water on every side.
Every fucking side. So don't look like we're going to Israel on foot.
Oh yeah, but, we gotta walk out to the wilderness.
Get our passport, give it to Sabat.
Yeah,
was that Sabat who did that shit?
That was the GOCC guy, wasn't it?
I can't remember. That was a long time ago.
One thing's a box that dumb.
I remember it though. And he took all their passports. Whoever did it, and they got stuck over there.
Yeah, that he took us. That took him to Egypt. Damn.
So,
yeah,
that was Egypt, wasn't it?
Why are you taking him to Egypt? Damn, we tried to get out of Egypt thousands of years ago. You trying to take him? You talking about a bad trip. They took motherfuckers to Egypt. Fuck.
Damn.
Of all fucking places to get stuck.
Of all places. All that chaos that's going on.
Yeah, all that. It took them over there during that revolt.
That place lost millions and millions of dollars in tourist money, man.
You got all kind of people starting in Israelite communities, too. Like that Pastor Dow guy.
I remember the one you sent me when the dude took him to the wilderness up out west somewhere.
Oh, yeah, that's the...
You sent me a link.
That's a... fuck. He's down with Pastor Dow. They made videos together.
You seen him? I remember the videos. They was actually out in the wilderness.
Yeah. I forget that guy's name.
We used to have fun climbing.
I think the name of his channel is Viking Preparedness. It's Show for Ministries or something. I forget his name. Joe something. Just a big fucking weirdo. Mm-hmm. Is what he is.
No motherfuckers left their jobs. They sold their possessions and they went to the wilderness. Small. And they probably still there, be honest with you. Esau can do that shit. Okay. You know? He can go to the wilderness and then just stay in that motherfucker. And all they did, they built a community out there in the wilderness, man. They still there.
Who you talking about? I'm sorry.
The dude, the link you sent.
Oh yeah, I was trying to think.
They was building up a community in the wilderness.
Man, they might have some truth too, because they know the Bible, they read it. But they read that scripture in Revelation 18, it says, come out of her, my people. That ain't talking about going out living in the wilderness. That's talking about the chariots beaming us up and taking us out of here.
That's right.
They ain't talking about going and starting a called up in the middle of the forest.
A new Exodus?
Yeah, a new Exodus. People are fucking crazy. You can't escape it. Come out of her, my people.
Because we going up into the forest and get them anyway.
You can't escape. You can't escape Esau. You can't escape the cops. Ain't nowhere you can hide. You're fucked.
You're fucked.
Until the Most High comes back.
That's right.
You got to live with this shit. Because where are they going to get their money? You know what I'm saying? How you going to have a job? You still got to pay taxes. They're going to get you, man.
Yeah, a lot of them are rich already, though.
Yeah, y'all, that's how they do it.
They was, because they sold a lot of their possessions. They sold all this shit, man. They went to the wilderness. They go back to the civilized world of life.
They got
supplies.
To. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, they go back and forth, you know.
So if you got to go get supply, you don't got, you know, he just living a lie.
Yeah, that's all they do. The missiles going to reach there, too.
Oh, the missiles are definitely there. They got a very... large blast radius, or what's it called?
Right.
I don't know.
Right, the blast that wind.
Yeah, the missiles will find you, man.
Woo! Fire has a way of lighting up that path to fucking
that fire, bro.
Those down ass people
will. Fuck this place, man. You got something? I got a scripture for them chariots. Those are making fun of people, man. You got something you want to read?
No. I was thinking about something else.
Let me read this real quick. Psalms 99, because like you said, when you're reading the book of Revelation, it says, come out of her, my people. That's talking about those chariots, the so-called UFOs. But check this out. Psalms 99 and 1. The Lord reigneth, let the people tremble. He sitteth between the cherubims, let the earth be moved. How is the earth going to be moved? Said the Lord is great in Zion, and he is high above all the people. Let them praise thy great and terrible name, for it is holy. So how are you supposed to praise the Lord's name when the name's holy? That means you got to teach the Lord's name, which is Yahweh.
I can only think of one thing that can move the earth, though, bro.
Yeah, that's it. You know? The earth is going to be moved. It's going to be shaking, quaking, cracking.
There's no mistaking the earth is quaking.
I can't wait.
Russia, who's Iraq? Yeah, Iraq said, or Turkey put troops in Iraq and they trying to get help from Russia.
Yeah, ain't that kind of funny how they shot the Russian jet for not going in as airspace, but they're in Iraq. You know?
But they,
that's some hypocrisy right there.
Russia just went through the Bosphorus Strait or whatever.
The one right that was supposed to block off?
And they went through this, right, passing right by Turkey with a Russian soldier had a rocket launcher on his shoulder pointing at him. They was just talking shit.
Wow. Man, Turkey know better. Man.
Turkey's gonna get fucked up.
Yeah, some big coming up. Yeah. Something huge coming.
They'd be the first ones in NATO to go down. Yeah.
I do see they scared to shoot the nukes up. I do see.
Oh, they definitely scared to shoot.
It's gonna be the most hot. It's gonna make them do it, man. Yep. They doing everything.
Them nukes is gonna get shot though.
Yeah, they're damn right.
Turkey's a NATO member.
Yep, that's all.
That means they gotta have nukes in Turkey, right? If they're a member of NATO, I bet they got nukes in Turkey somewhere.
I'm thinking of Ezekiel. I think the 39. Ezekiel 39. When the most. Let me
put the hooks in the jaws.
Yeah, he's gonna make them. Doomsday plane over here.
Yeah, the Doomsday plane. That's what they send out before they drop nukes and shit.
Cause they don't want to. Them motherfuckers are faggot, man. They see this shit is coming place, man. They like, whoa, what the fuck going on? This shit is getting out of control. We gotta do something to check this. And they come back with some fucking economic sanctions. What the fuck are you war plane with shotgun?
Yeah, it exists.
Didn't they kill the president because he didn't want to fucking bomb Hiroshima?
Huh? Are you talking about, they claimed that, some people say, yeah, that Roosevelt was poisoned because he didn't want to drop bombs. That's why they put Harry Truman in there. I mean, it might be true.
Here you go, Ezekiel 39:1. Yeah, it might be some truth to that.
Yeah.
It might be.
You never know.
But you know.
Because Roosevelt's a devil anyway.
Right.
He's the one that started World War II to begin with.
He was the one that couldn't walk. Was
yeah.
In a wheelchair?
Yeah. He got sicker and sicker as mm-hmm. he went. I've heard a lot of people say he was poisoned. But good for him. I'm glad he got poisoned and dropped dead. He's the one who invented the whole fucking socialist society.
Oh, you got that. That's that shit right.
What's
there.
What's that?
That graph that shows the power of nuclear missiles. That's beautiful, man. I like to make a video and put that graph up. Pull it up.
You know? Oh, that big ass thing?
Yeah,
you can't
see it. Shit, ain't it?
To properly, yeah, do that, you'd have to make a video.
I show someone on a tablet, my tablet. You know, and they was like speechless, man. Like, America got stronger nukes than that. Like, where's where? What's his name?
Show me. Yeah, what's it
what's
called?
What's his name? When did they drop it? Russia dropped Russia exploded the largest explosion here on the planet.
What was that, the Tsar bomb?
Besides what the Lord did to Sodom and Gomorrah, Russia built the largest explosion here that, you know, other than what the Lord did. And it wasn't America. America.
Fuck America.
America. Therefore, thou son of man, prophesy against Gog and say, thus saith the Lord power, behold, I am against thee, O Gog, the chief prince of Meshech and Tubal, and I will turn thee back and leave but the sixth part of thee, and will cause thee to come up from the north parts, and will bring thee upon the mountains of Israel. And I will smite thy bow out of thy left hand, and will cause thine arrows to fall out of thy right hand. So the Most High is going to cause it.
Yeah, they're going to shoot those missiles. Them arrows is missing.
Yeah. Motherfucking politicians and shit, they living deliciously, man. They don't want to ruin that.
Hell no.
So they gonna just put their wars, they think it's just gonna be done through political shit, sanctions and all that dumb shit. And what little bit of proxy wars they doing in Turkey, Iraq, Syria, whatever bullshit they doing there. They think that's the largest, they gonna get it.
Yeah, fuck your sanctions, man.
You know, sanctions, man.
Some stupid the Lord sanctioned some missiles.
You know what I'm saying?
And sanctified the missiles.
Stupid shit. They're funny, man. Esau ain't nothing but a faggot.
He's a big
ain't
faggot.
But a coward,
that's
man.
Why. That's why there's faggot shit out here. That's why it's okay to be a faggot. That's why faggots can get married. Because this is some faggot shit out here.
On the bus, so you ain't gotta drive in the fucking circle.
What you want? I don't give a fuck. I don't mind. I don't really mind driving home.
Yes. Every side of town, north, south, east, and west.
Every side of town.
That's some faggot shit. Now, I gotta catch a goddamn bus tomorrow to go to work. Faggot ass, faggot shit out here.
Hey, it's part of oppression. It's part of being oppressed, bro.
Yeah.
You know?
I knew it was just a matter of time.
Isaiah 24:18, and it shall come to pass that he who fleeth from the noise of the fear shall fall into the pit, and he that cometh up out of the midst of the pit shall be taken in the snare. For the windows from on high are opened, and the foundations of the earth do shake.
Foundations of the earth do shake. How does the windows from up high open? That's talking about that destruction that's coming.
We gonna laugh with these fools. The earth is utterly broken down. The earth is clean dissolved. The earth is moved exceedingly. The earth shall reel to and fro like a drunkard, and shall be removed like a cottage, and the transgressions thereof shall be heavy upon it, and it shall fall and not rise again. That's Esau and his power.
Yeah, so when this shit's destroyed, it ain't coming back. Not this faggot ass shit.
You mean to tell me they gonna make a miraculous comeback? Like the Lion Jew said that we the comeback kids of all kids.
Oh, yeah.
He said we're the comeback kids.
Well, like Alex Jones says, we're going to save America. Yep. We're going to turn this thing around.
Oh, you hear Donald Trump on there the other day?
Yeah,
Donald Trump is saying, we're going to make America great again.
Yeah, that's his big. That's his slogan, ain't it? That's what's going to get him.
He's like, we don't do it in the next 4 to 8 years, it's over with.
This shit's already over.
And people falling for that shit, too.
Alex Jones was right along with him. He was like, Donald, I see your plan. It's all laid out right before us. We can make America great again.
Yeah, I mean, fuck that shit. And then Donald Trump was talking about 9/11. He was talking like he accepted the official story and everything. Wow. Well, fuck that shit, man. I'm trying to hear that.
He's still right there giving them speeches.
Hey, but that. Donald Trump, there was an episode of The Simpsons that came out. I don't know how old it is. But it said that Donald Trump became the president in The Simpsons.
Oh, and that one idiocracy in the movie, they had the wrestler as a president.
Oh, man.
So Jesse Ventura is going to be his vice president.
Oh, that would be terrifying.
And that big ass right there.
Oh, my God.
No, that shit is rotten.
But Jesse right, Ventura. Yeah, that Jesse Ventura is a devil. That faggot, he's just a guy. You know, he's an atheist.
Satanist.
Yeah, he's definitely, he's into some secret cult societies or something.
He talks like a damn devil.
Talks like he has a cock in his mouth.
His son's a douchebag too.
Yeah, big fucking douchebag.
Who you talking about?
Jesse Ventura.
Oh, man.
He got a foul spirit on him. I don't like him. I used to like him back in the wrestling days with him and Gorilla Monsoon.
Jesse the Body?
You know when he did the commentary with Gorilla Monsoon?
Yeah.
But I don't even want to hear his ass talk now, man. He's a fucking atheist.
Playing his role, isn't he?
Yeah, he's playing his role. Just confusing people.
Yeah, it's his role. That's why he's making the money he's making.
Yeah, making
good
money.
He's playing his role, doing his job. And he's doing his job very well because he's loved.
He is loved.
He's loved. He's loved. And only the unrighteous men in society are going to be loved. The righteous men are going to be hated.
That's why he got beat up by that dude from the American Sniper. What's that dude?
Yeah.
Michael Cowell.
That ended up in court, didn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that dude dead?
That's some faggot shit to go to Esau for
suing somebody after they're dead.
Yeah, that's a devil for you. Going to Esau for justice.
Yeah, going to Esau. You got to get justice. There ain't no fucking justice.
What's the scripture
here
say? I dare any of you go to the law of the unjust. He say, I dare you. I dare you.
Yeah, you ain't going to get no justice out here.
What happens? What you mean by when somebody dare your ass to do so? That means a threat.
Yep.
And that's scripture. I dare you to go to the law of the unjust. These bitches collecting child support. I dare you to go to the law of the unjust.
Because really, their laws ain't even laws at all.
That's right. Man, that's some unlawful shit.
Woo! Faggot ass court system. Oh, it's a,
woo!
That shit is put in place just to keep your ass enslaved, not to give you no justice.
Bitches. I used to fuck with a bitch that worked at child support. She told me the majority of most bitches come down there on some emotional shit.
Yeah.
Just to get the nigga fucked up.
Yep.
Oh, I'm in here. She a hoe.
And all these bitches, they deserve to get put to death, and here they get rewarded. So you know this shit's backwards as hell.
And look, I was talking to this adulterous ass bitch. I gave her the scriptures. She was laughing at the scriptures. She was like, ah, the Lord ain't gonna destroy shit. Why am I still living good? But then a bitch had nerve to come to me and ask me, why is the Lord doing this? Why do I keep having miscarriages? Wait a minute. You laughed this shit to the... You laughed at the Bible, remember, bitch? Oh, adulterous hoe.
That's why we laugh at the people when they drop dead, they get fucked up.
We laugh at them, right. Especially after we gave them the truth. They ain't want to hear it. They ain't want to hear it. That bitch actually laughed at me on Facebook and everything. Ha, 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 ha. Where's the destruction? Because they was all celebrating Obama coming into office. Nigga, we moving up. We black people moving up. Ha. We moving up, yeah.
That's a good joke.
I'm laughing, my mom. I'm laughing. Okay.
Ain't nobody moving up.
Okay. Moving on up.
But they say
the Jeffersons.
They always talk about how the divide between the 1% and the 99% gets bigger every day. There's no middle. They're erasing the middle class.
Where'd they get that 1%?
Middle class.
Well, they said middle class is people who make what?
30,000?
No, more than like 100,000 or more. But yeah, 30,000 ain't middle class.
Fucking poverty.
Yeah. Middle class is like motherfuckers who's just doing well.
No, they used to say middle class was anything over like 35,000.
That's middle class.
Underneath of that is poverty.
I thought it was 30.
Yeah, it's something like that.
Middle class. And middle class is one check from being homeless.
Yeah.
Ain't no such thing as middle class. That's either rich or poor. Man.
And it tells you there's a class system in this country. Really? And people are like, oh, in other countries they have class systems.
Most.
I'm gonna look that up.
Bro. Average lease is like 5,000, 7,000 a year. You're making 30,000, that's like 10% of your paycheck.
I bet
just
I
for rent
plus
and bills.
Plus taxes. But yeah, everyone's fucking slaves out here. Financial slaves. If you do got a good job and you make good money, they're taking fucking all your money. There ain't nothing you can do about it.
Nothing you can do, but complain. Motherfucker.
You better off being homeless, living in the shelter, going to the soup kitchen every day.
Yeah. Living out here in this faggot ass.
You know what, the way my love going to curses, man, I can never live that comfortable out in the woods. I can never get that lucky.
They'll start train hopping and shit.
I know this one kid, he was doing real good last year. Now he's sleeping in a tent out in the woods.
Yeah. So you don't know what could happen from second to second. You don't know if you're going to be alive from right now to the next second. You got these dumbass bird brain bitches walking by and gazing upon us.
This phone, this might be listening to us, man, because I started typing in middle class income.
Oh, yeah, it's got a microphone.
It came up already. Okay. Middle class income range.
You could talk into it and it'll pop up.
That shit's probably about to die, ain't it?
I don't know. Halfway. Probably
middle
40
class
minutes.
Middle class consists of all Israel anyway.
Yeah.
That's all Israel.
You got the rich and the poor, that's all it is.
Yeah. My poverty line, as of 2009, the poverty threshold, as determined by the U.S. Census Bureau, had not changed since 2006. For a family of four, it was $21,203. For a family of three, it was $16,530. For a family of two, unrelated individuals.
Oh, that's for poverty.
Yeah, it goes up.
So 21,000? Damn. You're poverty.
You're middle class if you make 22,000.
So anything above that is...
you call that middle class? I don't know.
You able to buy a TV and maybe a couch to sit on?
You got a TV and a couch, you made it to the middle class.
Hey,
welcome,
man,
aboard.
I was watching yesterday this bitch on TV. Esau hyped her up.
Your dude got a wizard hat.
Sure does.
This bitch was asking people for money to help her get gifts and toys for her kids for Christmas. But I was looking at this bitch. This bitch had, and tattoos are not cheap.
Oh, no.
This bitch was covered with tattoos all over her body. I was just thinking, I mean, this bitch wasn't using the money for the tattoos to take care of the kids, though. This bitch probably
I gotta get
to
my ink gun.
Probably so. Yeah, because that shit is expensive.
Yeah, that shit, yeah, that is expensive, man.
I'll never waste my money on no dumbass shit. Fucking tattoos. Yeah, cause yeah, like I'm definitely under that poverty line. So shit.
It says this.
I'm trying to get some deals. I shop at thrift stores. motherfucking digging the trash. I'm keeping it real, bro. You know, I would dive. If I see some good shit in the trash, I'm diving in. You best believe it.
Economics, Gary Berlitz of Brooklyn Institute indicate that the middle class encompasses from one half the median income to twice the median income. This would make the middle class income range from $25,117 to $100,466 in 2019. Economics Frank Levy believes that those in the middle
class.
Right, that's a Jew.
There you go. She's bending over for you.
Enough money to afford the basic building blocks of a good life, including a house, a car, and money to pay necessary bills. He suggests that the families in their prime earning years are middle class if they fall between $30,000 and $90,000.
I don't know anybody making $90,000.
I know a lot of them. Yeah. Well, that's people I know.
That's paid though. You know, really, $90,000?
Yeah, that is paid.
That's you're doing good.
Really good.
Like I said, I don't know anybody.
Vacations.
Most people you know in the hood make what? $30,000-$40,000. Uh-huh. I mean, that's if they're workers. They've been in the same job.
And then they go to work 6 days a week.
Yeah, going to work 6 days a week.
Exactly. They like working though. They like to work though.
And that's all they do. They work, eat, sleep, and shit. And that's it. And that's their life from
fat.
And maybe get 2 weeks off a year.
What kind of fucking life is that, man?
Right, 2 weeks or a week. Depending on how long they have the job.
These people don't have, you can't even live your life. You're just going to work to do some dumb shit all day. It makes some asshole
and
rich.
And shit ain't even relevant what you do at your job.
It's just insignificant. You just wasting your fucking life away.
Bitch
doing
a
bunch
of
dumbass shit.
That's some funny shit.
You see, if everybody cared about truth, which they do not, you know, we should be a lot different, but hey, we don't live in fantasy land. We live in reality.
I guess I can say we was up there, me and Karen, we was up there. That was back in the day, though. That was back in the day. And you know, shit, you can do a lot of shit. You can do a lot of shit. That's how I took it all the way, though. You can do a lot of shit.
You can do a lot of shit with a little bit of money, if you're not stupid.
If you're in the right mind. If you're in the right mind.
I don't make much money, but I still manage to get shit.
Right.
You know, the Lord will hook you up, man.
Sure will.
I'll be fine. Like I told you, I used that computer I had. For 5 years, I used this computer. I found it right in the trash can. Maybe it wasn't 5 years.
Filled with roaches.
Yeah, I just had to clean the roaches out, but then it was good to go.
Shit, I had my computers since the beginning.
You still got some of them old raggedy computers?
Yeah, I still got them. Still working fine, too.
Man, that's that Linux
I still
on it.
Got them. You remember them Dells? Them Dell computers?
Yeah. Dells make good computers.
Still working.
I like Dells.
With that Linux on it. Still working like a brand
new
computer.
Yeah, you get some Linux, you'd be all right.
You know?
I can't be having no old computer no more. I can't take that. I'll be on a computer too damn much for that shit. Oh, slow-ass, loaded
pages.
Dial-up
speeds.
My Jew bitch, she buy a new computer, a new laptop, damn near every year, man. She buy a new one.
Oh, yeah, Cal told me 1 year his shit was outdated. It's real slow, it's outdated.
I got mine's badass. I feel like I should have waited and got a better one. But fuck it. You can't keep up with that shit. Hey, I got a scripture I wanted to read the rest of this Psalms 99. What was that? Drop my notes.
Relax and take notes.
Yeah, no, don't say that.
Cheat sheet.
No, I don't know what, that's from years ago or something. There's some notes I took years ago. Psalms 99 and 5. Exalt ye the Lord our God and worship at his footstool, for he is holy. Moses and Aaron among his priests, and Samuel among them that call upon his name. They called upon Yahweh, and he answered them. Let's check this out. He spake unto them in the cloudy pillar. They kept his testimonies and the ordinances that he gave them. That pillar, that's talking about that so-called UFO. It's that chariot. Thou answered them, O Lord our God, thou wast a God that forgavest them. Lowdown took his vengeance of their inventions. Exalt the Lord our God and worship at his holy hill, for he is Yahweh, our God is holy. But that's the point I wanted to bring out, because that whole scripture at first, when you go back to the top, when we started Psalms 90:91 again, says the Lord reigneth, let the people tremble. He sitteth between the cherubims, let the earth be moved. Because when that talk about is the pillars of smoke and all that, and when the Lord returns to the earth in those chariots, the earth is going to be moved. What's that, Revelation 1? What's that Revelation 1 say? Revelation 1 and what is that, 7? Behold, he cometh with clouds. Every eye shall see him, and they also which pierced him, and all kindreds of the earth shall wail because him. Even so, amen. So when the Lord comes back, he's coming with clouds. He's coming back in them chariots. Like that psalm said I just read, the earth is going to be moved. What's that scripture you read? It said the earth is going to rock to and fro like a drunkard.
What can I say? He's saying, you mean that black man gonna crack on clouds? So he's a non-believer. He can't even visualize that in his mind. We read the scriptures, we can see it. He made mockery of it. He can't see it. He couldn't see it at all. Just like a lot of these people, they can't see it.
But they claim they believe in some Egyptian shit.
Mm-hmm.
But you call them out on the Egyptian beliefs, I'm like, okay, do you worship the Apis bull? And you worship cats, right? And they was like, oh, they didn't really worship him, though. Man, of course they did. What are you, stupid? They built temples for cats and bulls. How stupid is that? Yeah, they get... Yeah, what kind of dumbass fucking belief system is that? You worship horse, the bird-headed god. And you worship a cat and alligators and crocodiles. Yeah, he's... There's some fucking roaches. Yeah, so anybody who believes any that Egyptian shit, you're fucking retarded. All right.
Retarded.
You're retarded. You're actually retarded. You know what I'm saying? You're void of reason, understanding. You're just a dumbass. You got to really be retarded to believe in that ancient Egyptian mythology. And that's the same thing as the Greek mythology, too. You got a lot of people who believe in Zeus still and all that shit. People are bugged out, man. But it's worse than that as a Muslim. We're going to talk about Muslims.
ISIS. All Muslims are ISIS.
Yeah, all Muslims are members of ISIS. Every last one of them. Fucking ISIS. But these people are good with Muslims coming in the country. Oh, all of a sudden, everybody hates Muslims, right? Man, we've been hating Muslims before that shit was cool.
I was tell you all, I was at the store on Black Friday. Went to Walmart. I forgot it was Black Friday.
Right.
It looked like a goddamn mosque.
It was at the Haji.
Where?
At Walmart. It was like nothing but goddamn Muslims up
right,
in there.
Right, right. Black Friday.
He thought he was at Mecca walking around the stone.
Black Friday.
I was going around running.
That Black Friday bullshit, that started from slavery.
Black Friday?
Yeah, it started from slavery. After Thanksgiving, at the end of the holidays, Thanksgiving, Christmas, the price of the slaves were cheaper, a lot cheaper.
I believe it, man.
That's Black Friday. It's the beginning of Black Friday. So going into the winter, you know, to get work done, motherfuckers out working, doing the coach, work is slow. So they was able to buy more slaves to get work done, you know. Black Friday. It's
fucked up.
Yeah, it's fucked up.
And you watch.
But they got people out Black Friday out fighting for war, man.
Just think, if motherfuckers would kill each other over a PlayStation
big
or a TV.
That's what they was doing to do. That's what they were doing. Going to war.
What you think they're gonna do when that's the last can of corn,
yeah,
or the last box of cereal at the store?
Last bottle of water.
Last bottle
pork
of water.
Chop.
It's gonna be a war.
Oh, it's gonna be beyond a war.
Yeah. You're gonna be biting holes in each other.
You're gonna see the real savagery come out.
That's right.
They already savages. Mm-hmm. That damn near damn near kill each other over a fucking TV.
Yeah. Sneakers.
Shit, they kill each other over $3.
Yeah. Tennis shoes.
Tennis shoes, Jordan. Get shot for some Jordans.
A bag of Doritos.
Yeah, you really get shot for a bag of Doritos. That's how grimy these motherfuckers are. There's some grimy pieces of shit motherfuckers out here. It ain't just people in the hood, it's all these motherfuckers.
Hey, when Daryl grew up in Pittsburgh, the part of Pittsburgh he grew up in, like back in the day when I used to go to Pittsburgh all the time, that was the most scariest place to be.
Really?
Because if you had anything new on, new shirt, shoes, damn. And if you in that area, you don't belong there, and you don't know motherfuckers, you hit. Where he from, man,
I had somebody back way years ago, I had somebody try to rob me for some Jordans. I luckily, through the spirit of the Lord, I got away.
Wow.
You know,
like, you ain't getting my Jordans and
my
took out running.
Yeah, that's what I did. I was like, you're going to have to shoot me to get these Jordans. And I just prayed and just took off running.
Right.
Dropped all your chains.
Yeah, he was on the bus of his Jordans.
Was your chain still there when you went back?
No, hell no. He probably took it. Because I was on my way to I had a shitload of pennies and chains. I didn't have no money, but I had some Jordans. But I was going to, go put my change in a machine to get
the
some money to buy groceries, you know, to eat. Because I didn't have... And here it is, this poor motherfucker's robbing me. We both ain't got nothing. You know what I'm saying? People are grimy.
That's crazy.
They going to go rob somebody who don't ain't got nothing.
Kim Jong-un?
Yeah, Kim Jong-un. Kim Jong-il is the one who went hard. Kim Jong-il, he's the good one. Kim Jong-il goes so hard. He was a movie director. He loved movies and cinema. And he loved making movies so much, he went to South Korea, kidnapped his favorite movie director.
He sure did, didn't he?
And forced his ass to make that movie.
He went and got it.
And made that movie Paul Gasari. Y'all seen
that's Paul? That's hard. That's somebody going hard right there.
Y'all seen Paul Gasari? Go watch it. It's a good movie. Yeah.
He went and kidnapped.
He went and kidnapped. I can't never get over that.
Yeah. That's crazy, going hard, man.
You go kidnap your favorite. That's like if somebody here, their favorite director was Steven Spielberg or something. Hey. They gonna kidnap him.
Right. Just like, you know, you ever watch Two Broke Girls? And two fine ass bitches and two broke girls.
Uh-uh.
Yeah, that's all I do is imagine breaking them bitches. I want to go and kidnap them. Man, you gotta watch Two Broke Girls. These are the finest bitches on TV, man. Both of them are fine as fuck.
What channel is that?
Two Broke Girls. You ever watch Two Broke Girls, man?
Me neither.
I watch that bullshit reality.
I heard that. They ain't reality though.
Bullshit television.
You're right.
The television is the devil.
Satan.
Two broke girls.
He said, at least
I'm the only one watching.
So I don't watch that bullshit.
It's a fine ass.
That's what I said.
It's like he was about to fight.
That's what I said. I don't watch that bullshit. He got you. I don't watch that bullshit.
You get me.
No, I was just fucking with
you. I love them bitches. You know, yeah. I love them bitches.
Like, you sure the hell is wearing some skinny jeans, though?
I don't have cable. I ain't got a TV. I could watch it if I wanted to.
Her? Y'all don't know? Y'all don't recognize her?
I've seen her before, yeah.
You trying to tell me she ain't hot? You got to see her. She built like a sister, man.
Yeah, I've seen her before.
She built like a sister. And the way she act, her personality is like she grew up in the fucking hood, man.
Oh, I did. Hey.
I downloaded this bitch's picture. I got it on my phone. You know what I'm saying?
Hey,
I had it as my screensaver, man, but my wife, she was like, I'll throw that motherfucking phone.
Hey, when
get it off. This is my phone.
Your fucking lights are not on, bitch.
It's my phone, bitch. Hey, you don't see no sisters? You see a cartoon sister on my phone.
You be dating.
Storm. But you don't see no black bitches on my phone, man. You don't see none, man. I don't want none of these black hoes, man. I want a honey that got some you know.
Oh yeah, these black bitches, they get scars, they don't go away.
Like freckles.
They get bumps on their ass. Shit, they got bumps on their ass for the rest of their life.
Hey, the Lord said you gonna have your heart's desire.
That's right, bro. Continue.
Hey, what's that scripture? But these churches ain't gonna teach you that though.
Hey.
They'll teach you that. You're fucking evil because you're attracted to the opposite sex.
That's right.
Have sex with the king.
right. Yeah,
oh, there's no sex in the kingdom. In the kingdom, we're not even going to have penises.
Oh, where's that?
We're going to be like Ken and Barbie dolls.
Where's that church at the pastor had his congregation sucking his dick?
Oh, yeah, wow. You see that?
No, bro.
That was down in Brazil, there's a preacher. He had all the old, I don't know if that's a real story.
Oh, I believe it.
It's got to be real.
Yeah, of course.
But he had that whole congregation believing that his sperm was a magical cream from God. And they had to drink it.
He must have seen Caligula.
He had, he had some woman, she was sucking it, thought she was the Lord's going to bless her.
Right.
They helped give her more business.
Wow.
He had all kind of. He got arrested.
The scripture says we're going to plant the heavens.
Yeah.
You know, so.
Yeah, that's a big universe to populate.
Right, and that cuts no sex in the kingdom. We're going to plant. I'll be trying to find that, bro. That's another one of them scriptures we ain't brought out forever.
Oh, that's why Corinthians says, because people use that scripture in Revelation and say that only the virgins are going to get saved. They don't understand that. The virgin is a metaphor, man. It means your minds are pure.
Fuck me. Peter wasn't a virgin.
Right, he had a wife.
Fuck.
Yeah, exactly. And he's part of the elect. The book of Peter, the very first scripture in Peter 1, it says, to the elect. Yeah.
I was trying to say, my book.
That's how your dick got the nickname Peter, because of Peter.
Peter is a Greek word that means a rock.
Peter, rock. Yeah, if you see it with you, I will plant this. I will build this.
That's not his real name. His real name was Simon, right. Or Simeon from the tribe of Simeon.
Simon,
well, heaven. Simon, yeah, because of good. Well, Simon, oh, Simeon, yeah. Simon it means yeah. Simeon, like the tribe of Simeon. It means right, here we go. Yeah, because Peter was a. Peter had a wife, right? Said Peter, an apostle of Yahushua, to the strangers. Oh, look at this. To the strangers scattered throughout Pontus, Galatia, Cappadocia, Asia, and Bithynia. So that means strangers. That means heathens are getting saved, right? They said they're strangers? That's talking about all these Israelites that were scattered throughout all these lands. It says elect, according to the foreknowledge of God the Father. Through sanctification of the Spirit, unto obedience and sprinkling of the blood of Yahushua, grace unto you and peace be multiplied.
The scripture.